Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. The big idea today is design, building things. And what are we going to design and build? A boat. A boat needs to be able to do two things, float and move through the water. Believe it or not, each one of these boats, yes, they float, but they also move through the water using different forms of energy. This boat uses magnetic energy. Next, we have chemical energy. Then we have electrical energy, heat energy, and this boat uses the energy of moving air. So where do we start with this design challenge? I like to start by having my students draw a picture of a boat they think will float and move through the water. Anywhere from 2 to 5 pictures is a really good starting point. Remember, students can work by themselves or they can work in a group, but the next step is to pick one picture and build that boat. These boats look so nice, but it's important to realize that it took a lot of redesigning, rebuilding, and retesting to make these boats work. It's design. Boats float, and I said they retest them and rebuild them. Where does all that happen? Well, I have a very scientific piece of equipment called a rain gutter, and I call this the Rain Gutter Raceway. I actually have a small section here for us to view, but in my classroom, I have a 10-foot long section of rain gutter that we fill up and we race our boats and test our boats and redesign our boats and rebuild our boats, all within the very comfortable Rain Gutter Raceway. So now let's get wet and take a look at these 5 boats in action. We're gonna start with the easiest one, the magnetic energy boat. I drop it in the water, and you can see it's gonna flip, which also could be part of my redesign. I use my magnet. I'm not touching the boat. I'm driving it down the channel, the raceway of the rain gutter, and you can see it move. The next one's a chemical boat. I'm gonna fill this with water, add some fizzy tabs, and watch that thing power down the rain gutter. Simply adding water, filling it up. Now the interesting thing, we talk about redesign, the amount of water I add actually has an effect on how well the boat works. I'm gonna drop in the fizzy tabs, which is actually gonna create a chemical reaction. You can see it happening. I have to do it rather quickly. If I put in too much water, my boat might not work as well. And you can see it slowly putt-putt down the rain gutter. Woo!
I don't see any effect coming back. Oh, there it is.
I see little bubbles.
And now for boat number 3, our electrical boat. Now something interesting happened here. When the students designed this, they stuck this electrical motor, it's just a little fan, on the back of the boat. They found that the fan, the electrical motor, was too heavy and the boat just really didn't float well. So they actually put a little tiny weight in the front of the boat to make it float better. Watch this thing move across the rain gutter. So I'm going to turn this on. And it slowly motors across the rain gutter. Slow and steady, look at her plod away. The mustache goes by. This is the best run you've had so far. Look at that thing.
Nice job!
Boat number 4 is the most complicated boat. It's actually made out of a little pie tin that we bent up and cut up to form our boat, but the motor, that's the complicated part. It uses heat energy. We actually heat up water, the water creates steam, and that powers the boat. To make that is the complicated part. The students took a soda can and cut it up, bent it up, and created this tiny little chamber that could hold water, and then they put straws into that little soda can and put glue, a special kind of glue called epoxy, all over it to seal it up. It sounds complicated, it actually is. And then you have to fill that with water using a dropper. It takes a little bit of time. The water's in the straws, now we need to heat that water. How? A candle, a birthday candle. We're gonna light the candle and let the water heat up. You can actually hear it heating. I'm gonna use my little lighter here to help things along. And it takes some time for it to heat.
Wow. Guys, that is neat for speed right there. You see that?
Yeah, I see that.
Oh my god, that is
shit. Whoa. play.
His boat is a lot lighter though. That was part of the problem.
And our last boat, boat number 5, uses the force of air under pressure. I'm going to blow up this balloon, and that balloon is going to force the air out of the straw and move it down my rain gutter raceway. Does it matter how big I blow the balloon up? Part of redesigning. Put it in my rain gutter raceway, and off she goes.
Woo!
That's so good.
It might make it.
Lexi!
It will make it.
Now, if you noticed, some of these boats went down the raceway quickly. Some not so quickly. Some didn't look like they moved much at all, but they did move. How fast your boat goes or how far your boat goes, it doesn't matter. This is a design challenge. All we care about is, can you make your boat float, and can you make it move through the water? To do that, you have to retest and rebuild and rework. That's all a part of design. Science is a really neat name for this designing and reworking and building things. They call it engineering. All students benefit from building challenges in engineering. This is just one of them. Science is so cool, or should I say, engineering is so cool. Don't forget to check out our links in the video description for more ideas on engineering challenges. Thanks for watching.